Hey folks, I'm Sam Luce here with iZotope. Today I want to take a look at parallel processing and how we can use it to create sounds that conventional processing may struggle to achieve. We can use it to add really extreme processed sounds into a mix, but just tuck them in underneath the original sound so you get the best of both worlds. You can bring them in using the mix controls and just blend them in so they sit underneath the original tracks. I'm going to be using Nectar and Neutron to achieve this, so make sure you get your free trials over at iZotope.com now, and let's just jump straight in. So in a nutshell, parallel processing is the practice of blending a compressed or otherwise affected signal in with a dry, unprocessed one. It's a simple but effective technique that can be deployed in a mix or master to bolster important track elements like drums, guitars, and more. Let's dig into some examples now. Typically, when we think about parallel processing on drums, we go straight to parallel compression. And although this is a great technique for adding some weight to your drums, here's another angle. We're going to use Neutron's transient shaper module on the drum bus to add some sustain. I'm going to bring the sustain control all the way up. Bring the width out to just under 30, and then bring the mix up to just over 20%. This is going to leave the transients alone, but add some sustain to the drum tails and add some real vibe to the sound. We're then spreading this out a little, so it's surrounding the listener and adding a whole new dimension to the drum mix. Trash 2 is one of my all-time favourite plugins to use in parallel. You can add weight, crunch, attack, and anything in between. Here I'm going to use it on a synth bass to bring up the higher harmonic content and add some grit to the sound. I've chosen the Tube Drainer plugin from the Drive menu, which is adding exactly what I was looking for. Once you've added that grit, you don't have to stop there. I feel like I'm not quite getting as much top end as I'd like. So I'm going to go across to the filter section and bring up some high end. Now these settings may look extreme, but just wait until you hear it in the mix. Parallel processing on vocals can help add character to your sound without detracting from the original tone and transient detail. Using Neutron's Exciter module, you can add some personality to your sound using the three global modes and saturation types. Here, I'm going to set the global mode to clear, as I want to retain as much of the intelligibility of the vocals as possible, while still giving it some character. I'm going to set the saturation type all the way to tube. This is going to give me a sound reminiscent of an older tube-style preamp, which I think is going to fit nicely with this track. I'll set my drive all the way up and blend in the effect using the mix fader. 'Cause I can't stop these thoughts, they come right through me like a machine gun. 'Cause I can't stop these thoughts, they come right through me like a machine gun. But don't feel like you have to stop there. If you want to smooth the sound out a touch, you can bring down the high end using the low pass filter. You can also split the effect into multi-band mode, so you affect different parts of the signal differently to really tune in the sound that you want. Or have the effect lie somewhere in between the saturation modes using the blend control to really tailor your sound. So sticking with the vocal here, we saw how thinking unconventionally, using transient shaping in parallel as opposed to the more typical parallel compression, can work wonders for the drum sound. Let's see if we can dig in a bit deeper to this vocal and use this same outside the box thinking. I'm going to apply two types of processing here to the vocal in the breakdown section, which I'm going to be automating. Take a listen to the result here, and then I'll show you how I've achieved the effect.
Right through me like a machine gun pierce.
I'm using two modules here to achieve this sound. The first is dimension, which we can choose between chorus, flanger, and phaser. In this instance, I've chosen flanger. And then I'm also going to be using harmony, which we'll come onto in a second. Importantly, I'm automating these modules so that the mix comes up only in a certain section. This is the breakdown section. Let's take a listen to this with and without the module engaged and hear how it's affecting the sound.
I can't stop these thoughts, they come right through me like a machine gun.
It's adding a 3D quality to the sound. It's adding that sort of ethereal touch, which is separating it from the rest of the track. And then we've got harmony. This is adding four harmony layers onto the vocal, and I'm automating them to ride up towards the end of the phrase. Let's take a listen without this engaged and then with, and you'll hear how these harmonies are sweeping up and surrounding the listener.
Right through me like a machine gun pierce.
Here I've chosen a perfect fifth and a super octave above to be roughly in the centre. Then I've got a major third above in the left hand speaker and a sixth below in the right hand speaker, which is the same as the major third, just in the octave below. I'm bringing the pitch correction all the way up to 100% to make these notes really precise on the harmonies. Let's take a listen to this without any of the effects engaged and then with them engaged, and we're going to hear a real difference.
Right through me, like a machine gun. Right through me, like a machine gun.
We've seen here how using the mix controls in Neutron and Nectar can help you to achieve parallel processing sounds that wouldn't have been possible in regular inline processing methods. Make sure you check out your free trials now at iZotope.com, and I'll see you again soon. Take care.